that Ty? That's not Ty. That's Eric Young. Wow, they all got into this game. This is Neville. No, it's... Oh, yeah. Alright, well, they're not going to really provide much for me. Hey, what's going on, everybody? Let's see if I can get into another... Oh, wait. Is that Nikki Cross in the back? Cool. I did not really talk to anybody else because, I mean, why? But let's see what talking to a diva would be like. Well, not diva. Okay, fine. Nikki Cross is just a crazy person, as usual. I did not mean to say diva. They do not use the term diva anymore. They are all superstars, which is awesome. So, women's wrestler, women's division wrestler, women's division superstar. Ready to get started? I was ready yesterday. Good, keep that attitude. Learn a few new things, moves and technique, sorta. You'll see what I mean as we're working today. Wrestling here is unique, hop in the ring and I'll show you. Oh, we're probably going to be going through like how to make a 5-star match, which is actually really tough. You have to basically allow yourself to get hit and knock down a bunch and get out of pins and stuff like that just to make a match 5 stars. But of course, you're working against the AI, so that's a lot harder than it sounds. Let me get a sip of my drink here. Yes, my drink has crunchy bits in it. Those are cacao nibs. I've been drinking a lot of monk fruit. I'll talk about this some other time, but it's a good drink. I just put actual cacao nibs in there so that I have something to kind of chew on because I really like cacao. Anyway. Oh, there's a few new things in the way the gameplay works. You can interrupt certain grapples to carry your opponent. Try performing a scoop slam by moving to the diagonal downward and pressing X at the same time. Then as you're lifting your opponent, hold R1. That's a lot of mechanics. There you go. You can complete the scoop slam. So holding R1 leaves them in that position. Bam! So everyone has a built-in scoop slam. You can also lift your opponent directly into a carry position by holding R1 and moving up, down, left, right with R. What the hell? How come I can't do it? What the hell? What the hell? How come I can't do anything? Restart match. Let's do this again. Alright. Yeah, by moving and... Okay. Then as you're lifting your opponent, hold R1. Whoops. What the hell just happened? There you go. I don't know why that didn't work. Is my controller getting weird? Okay, let's try this again. Oh, with the right stick. I'm an idiot. There you go. There you go. If you carry, if an opponent has you in the carry position, you can try to escape from it from the following way. Hold pressing circle, I believe. Yes. Circle, 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 circle. Yeah. 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 All right. Great. This ends the carry tutorial. Great. La 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 la. La 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 la. Okay. Loading screens will be sippy time. Let me tell you. Monk fruit extract is like the best. It's the best thing. Does not raise blood sugar one bit. And it tastes so good. It doesn't have the bitterness of stevia. Anyway. What's up, Matt? It feels pretty intuitive. I mean, there was a tutorial. Is that it for today? Don't tell me that's it. Oh, okay. There we go. Speak with him again. There's no one around here that I want to talk to. So let's get back to talking. Submissions. Am I going to be able to pick which version of the submission machine I'll be able to use? Or mechanic, I should say, not machine. Machinic. Machinic. Maybe that's the way I should call it. I'm not going to sip every single time there's a loading screen. Because then right after the loading screen is done, I'm going to be like, okay, just chewing on something. Submission should be fun. I did give... So I practice a form of martial arts, Filipino martial arts, where there is an MMA component to it. Essentially, we do strikes, weapons, and also groundwork. And because we do groundwork quite a lot, I tend to gravitate to a lot of groundwork moves when I create a character these days. So one of my favorite moves is actually the Kimura Lock. It actually makes perfect sense, the way that the Kimura Lock works. There are two options for submission control this year. We will show you both the options. You can choose which one fits your style best. Option one, hold X to initiate submission and R to manipulate the sliders. So the sliders, I've always hated. Like, the slider thing, yeah, this is so dumb. Use R to move your slider around. The attacker controls it. Yes, I know how this works. If it comes to me, right, press L2 to give it a boost. Be careful, you will consume more your stamina and make your slider more difficult to control. Make sure you grab the green orb to increase your chance of success. Come on. Yeah, see, that's the thing. Like, it's a constant struggle. It's a constant struggle. It's so... And the... It just feels so freaking janky most of the time. Ah, tap out, you bastard. Here we go. Rapidly press the display. This is a lot better. It actually feels like you're fighting against the thing. It doesn't just feel like a janky, like, circle. So this makes a lot more sense. So hold. Put him in the half Boston Crab. All right. Rapidly press the indicate button to fill the meter with your color. Pressing the wrong button will fill with the opponent's color. See, this makes a lot more sense to me. Fills completely red, you will submit them. Triangle, X, circle. Bam. A lot easier. It doesn't have to be easier, but it just has to make more sense. Good. That's always good, Tommy. Loading screen again. Here we go. So I guess once I get out of the performance center, it's going to be easier to just go match, 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 match. So we'll see how that goes. That freaking Bruno Mars song is just stuck in my head now. Oh, that was a pretty quick one. Good, good. Not at all, you're natural. I prefer rapidly press. Nice. Good, that's all for today. All right, cool. Maybe I can jump into the next episode. Next day, I should say. And we can go through what's going to happen there. We're probably going to end up... I don't know when we're going to do the 5-star stuff. That's pretty common for the 2K games. There's always some sort of rating because it's like a simulation. It's not really arcadey, so the fun that you get from this game really depends on just how fast-paced you want it to be. But that's the reason why I like being a gamer, is because I can always pick up this game if I want to just have, like... more chill times, and then I'll pick up something like Marvel vs. Capcom, which I do have to continue playing, of course. I have to pick up Marvel vs. Capcom if I want something more fast-paced, more frenetic, if you will. Here we go. La 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 la. Oh, snap. Hey, I can go in. Okay, I'll go in for like a second. How do I get in there? Okay, L1. Can we fight... Go bother someone else. I came in here for nothing! Nothing! Yeah, the facial movements. Some people were saying that the facial movements for a lot of these characters is on the level of Mass Effect Andromeda. Now, before you guys ask, I'm not going to continue recording my gameplay of... Who's this over here? Is that Hideo? That's Hideo. I'm not going to continue recording my gameplay of Mass Effect Andromeda. That thing... The whole story behind that game just became... Like, I still think it's fun. I still enjoy it. I'm going to play it using PS4 Remote Play more often. But overall, it was just like... It was just so funny how much of a crap show that the story of that game was. Like, everyone was crapping on it a bunch, even though a lot of people said it was fun, but the facial animations were pretty crazy. Ooh, who am I gonna go up against? Oh, Baron's already in there. Cool. Alright, so... I don't think people should be saying it's as bad as Mass Effect Andromeda. It should have been the other way around. Mass Effect Andromeda had problems that the 2K series generally has. Well, you're in luck. Now is as decent time as any time. All right, let's do it. If I don't have to make a 5-star match, I'm just going to try and finish this as quickly as possible. Mm-hmm. Then I'll take a small break. That's what I'm thinking. Like, I want... Okay, so full disclosure, the Pixel 2 review came out today, and I spent all weekend working on it. And I got a lot of sleep last night, but it feels like I didn't get a lot of sleep because I slept super late. Oh, here we go. Always start this off. Oh, what? Okay. What? He gave me End of Days already? What? What the hell? Oh, what the hell was that? That was such a dick move. And I panicked, so I wasn't able to kick out of the pin. Oh, that was so dickish. Well, that's Baron for you. Matt Bloom's like, all right, you're fired. Get out of here. Anyway, what I was saying earlier. he gave me the guns. He's like, good job, kid. what I was saying earlier is that I wasn't able to play any gameplay footage. So I went ahead. I'm just playing this right now. It's Monday. I'm chilling out. I'm trying to. He's holding my arm. Tell me what the hell that was all about. I want a rematch. What? That I should accept losing. I did not mean to have a defeatist attitude there. Losing is one possibility when you enter that ring. Possibility. I probably would have had a wrong answer no matter what. That ring contains every possibility, so I have to prepare for every outcome, win, lose, anything in between. Sure. Also know this, that nothing is possible when you're not in there. Oh, wow. There's something oddly inspirational about all this. You gotta fight to get in there, and you gotta fight to stay, you gotta fight to fight. I'm not dead. Like, can't expect to breach through everyone, keep progressing, and comes a time you can squash someone like Baron Corbin can. Which is funny, because for a while there, Baron Corbin didn't seem to have, like, the best wrestling ability. He was just end of dazing everybody, if that's the way I can put it. I just got my ass handed to me, and you're ready to make the jump to NXT. What the hell? This game is so janky. Call him when I see him. I see you there laying down some incredible smack. Show up backstage next week and we'll tell you where to go from there. Thank you, Matt. You bet. One morning. Congratulations. Be rooting for you. My path starts here, everybody. My path starts here. It only took 2 episodes and a finisher to the face, but I made it to NXT. Not a whole lot of buildup. They're kind of throwing you in the deep end, but maybe that makes a bit of sense because you have 3 different places that you can go here. Like, you can go through NXT, and then you can go to either Raw or SmackDown. And then after that, it's a bunch of the pay-per-views when you're actually going through like the really heavy hitting stuff, trying to get to WrestleMania. So adding another layer to that, which is just the performance center. And if that can take at least like an hour or two, I mean, that's just a bit of a slog. So I don't see a huge problem with the kind of fast pace of this early part of my career part. So yeah, let's jump in. It's just one of those things where NXT is where you're going to learn the ropes, get some of your initial moves. You do have to make sure that you do a good job. So there's that to keep in mind. So actually, I hear the crowd. So I'm going to go in and go into the next episode right away. Enjoy your tea, everybody.